have too much attention alone and you partner them together, they'll have more exposure and the audience for one business can now be exposed to a very separate business and vice versa. So with that being said, you have two different companies having access to new markets as well. So if they're two very different companies, now they're exposed to new consumers as well. And this can also help reduce costs in some ways. And with the two companies put together, you have a better technology as well sometimes. One of my first illustration, this is a more of an example of a strategic alliance. So Sony is also popular, known for their gaming systems, their audio, and all their communications. And Ericsson is known for more of also communications and a leader in broadband internet. So combined, you have the Sony Network Communications. Together, they were taking charge in the mobile and internet sector all over the world on a global status. And soon after they were hitting such great success, Sony being the stronger company, later took over both as one. They became one company at the end. My second illustration is more of an example of a joint venture. So everybody knows about Ford. They have great SUVs. And Eddie Bauer is known in the clothing segment. Their markets are more for high-end leather jackets, quality sportswear. Together, you have a more luxury designed SUV attracting customers for that in that market. And then you have the name of Ford supporting Eddie Bauer. So people who would normally support Ford vehicles are now exposed to Eddie Bauer's clothing stuff, and people who would normally not might be shopping in Eddie Bauer that bought Ford are gonna more likely to buy from Eddie Bauer. So Eddie Bauer's leather was used inside of the cars and the leather seating. And then when Eddie Bauer did luggages, they used Ford's name because of the durability and reputation. So for my application, I thought about the current situation we're facing in the world right now. We have an environmental crisis going on with global greenhouses and all the crazy stuff. So you have, for my first example I was thinking of, was all the mom and pop companies that are trying to get ahead of the curve by having solar panels. Imagine all the new homes, if they partnered up, if different companies partnered up with those mom and pop solar panels, then that could be a great exposure and help the environment. My other one is the disposable diapers. These are reusable diapers. So if the reusable diapers partnered up with a bigger diaper company like Pampers or Huggies, then you can definitely have a better environment where people are using diapers in this form instead of disposing them in millions by the day. And my third one was, these are bamboo straws, and if you know, straws are ruining our oceans right now and affecting marine life. If we use reusable bamboo straws and other materials, mom and pop companies that are kind of making this and entering that segment can get more exposure and help the environment, and it'll help promote other businesses as well. And for my implication, I was just thinking about if tech companies, fashion companies, engineers, artists, and connoisseurs of different sorts, imagine if you took two separately different people that have all the ideas and all the plans, and you put their brains together and you put their companies together, you can come up with all sorts of different improvements in the future. So you have this quote from George Washington, however, when you can do a common thing in an uncommon way, you will command the attention of the world. And basically, if you switch up something that seems normal by putting two brains together, and everybody scratch theirs back, I scratch yours, you scratch mine, we're all happy, and the consumers are happy as well. And that will be it for mine. I'm gonna hand it over to Eric.